Hi, my name is Heather Heat Hardy, and you're watching Blue Blood Sports TV.
This is Amanda, the real deal Serrano, and you're watching Blue Blood Sports TV.
Hi, I'm Courtney.
And I'm Janita.
And you're watching Blue Blood Sports TV.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, WBC, undefeated British Lineal Heavyweight World Champion Tyson and Gypsy King Fury responds to all the allegations about the gloves, about the farmer coming out and blowing a whistle on him, essentially. Tyson Fury comes out with a message saying that I was going to run a marathon, but obviously that can't happen due to the circumstances. But don't worry, I'll be back to save the day, Bob Arum, Frank Warren. He tags them, he says, don't worry, I'll be back to save the day wearing a Batman costume. And his friend is wearing a Robin costume. This is what Tyson Fury wore, if you guys remember, in the whole buildup in the situation with Vladimir Klitschko, when he was going back and forth with him in the buildup for their fights. And the second fight didn't come to fruition, obviously. But the first fight, Tyson Fury won and dethroned Vladimir Klitschko as the reigning heavyweight unified world champion. Tyson Fury has went back to this, put on the Batman costume, and telling Frank Warren, who was his promoter in the UK, and Bob Arum, who's his promoter in the States. Bob Arum, obviously the CEO and promoter of Top Rank with ESPN. He has a deal signed with ESPN for Top Rank to showcase their fights on ESPN platform. Frank Warren is his promoter in the UK. And so Tyson Fury is assuring them and telling them, don't worry about everything that's taking place. We'll be back to save the day. Well, I'll be back to save the day with his Batman costume, right? Tyson Fury's career is in jeopardy with this gentleman, this farmer, Martin Carefoot, who's coming out and stating that Tyson Fury pretty much bribed him to testify in the court that he provided Tyson Fury and his team with tainted meat, with wild boar meat that was tainted. And now he's coming out and he stated that that's not the case. Indeed, that they were offering to pay him £25,000 to state this, right? To cover up his UCOD test. Also, we know the situation with Tyson Fury's gloves, Glovegate, with both his fights with Deontay Wilder. Now it's come out with Christian Hammer, and also in the fight with Derek Cisora as well. You can see there is definitely some tampering with his gloves. You can see Ricky Hatton, former world champion in his own right, countryman of Tyson Fury and friend, pull down his left glove. You can see the left glove flapping around. It looks like his knuckles could be in the wrist area. So Tyson Fury is in a bit of hot water. I'm pretty sure Tyson Fury hears all the allegations and everything that's taking place. And this was his response with a Batman costume. And lets the world know, and lets his promoters, more importantly, Bob Arum and Frank Warren know, don't worry, I'll be back to save the day. Frank Warren responded by saying, that costume looks familiar, with laughing emojis. So, you know, Frank Warren tried to come out and he tried to debunk the notion that this farmer, Martin Carefoot, is just reaching out and just in need of money. He stated that he asked Frank Warren for money to cover up the case. But the thing is, why would he even go to Frank Warren to say that he would cover up the case if there's nothing fishy going on? So, you know, we got to see how this all plays out. Tyson Fury is always a jokester. He's always, you know, happy-go-lucky, and he seems to take everything lightly. These are serious situations going on. He took the case with, you know, the UCOD lightly, you know, and then it came out that he was using recreational drugs, and Tyson Fury stated that he did participate in using those things. That's what, you know, his failed test was about. But, you know, there's a lot going on with Tyson Fury currently. Tyson Fury always lets it be known that he suffers from mental health issues, you know, and depression. And these are things that's, you know, he just has a track record, a long track record in the history of, you know, bending the rules, point blank and period. There's no other way to say it. So we have to see how this all plays out. Martin Carefoot is under investigation himself because it's perjury, right? He lied in the court of law. So, you know, he's facing charges himself. So he's willing to walk through the fire to, you know, to have Tyson Fury found guilty, because he's saying he's now has found the conscience. He's stating that, you know, he no longer wants to have the burden of lying to the public, and he believes the world should know. And he wasn't compensated for the money that he was owed. So Martin Kerfoot is coming out, and then we see all the video evidence of the glove gate. So, you know, there's a lot going on with Tyson Fury. He hasn't done too many interviews. He hasn't been in a public limelight. He hasn't responded to any allegations, but this is the first time he responded. He stated that, you know, he was gonna blow some steam running a marathon, but obviously we know what the world is going through currently with the virus, and he's saying that that's not possible. So, but he did tell Frank Warren and Bob Arum, he left them a message saying, you know, don't worry, I'll be back to save the day. So let's see how this everything plays out. But I believe that, you know, Tyson Fury is taking this a bit lightly. I believe Tyson Fury is feeling a bit of Teflon, like he's untouchable in this situation. Maybe he feels he truly, you know, doesn't care. You know, Tyson Fury has a mentality of where he'll, one day he cares about the sport of boxing, and the next day it doesn't matter to him. So maybe the sport in his career just doesn't matter to him at this point in time. Who knows? But let's see how this all plays out. But that's all I got for y'all. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.
Hey, this is Jasmine. Thank you for watching Blue Blood Sports TV. Hola, soy Jasmine. Gracias por ver Sangre Azul Deportes TV. Gracias.